Hey y'all, I am so excited to share how we're staying on top of it all this garden season. We have partnered with SEEDTIME, who is offering free software. This is free, what I'm showing you. And you get $5 of free seeds to whoever's interested. So I want to show you why I love this new software, and it is making it so much easier for me. I don't have to keep going on Google and searching when to do things, because I don't remember stuff so well. Here we go. All right, y'all. Now, once you click on the link to download this software, it'll bring you to this page, and we're gonna put raised garden bed, or the name of my garden. You can put like 7A, 7B, and then it will input your spring last frost and your last hard frost, and it'll input your first frost and your first hard frost. This is my calendar. I'm gonna go to today, so I clicked on today. These blue on my calendar, these are the frost dates, and then it gets light blue. So these are the days that it's far less likely for you to get a frost. And then we get into white days over here. And this white means you're not going to be getting a frost according to past data. Over here on the left, these are all of the plants that I have input into their system for my garden this year. And the nice thing is I just had to write the word beets and it pulled up different varieties, and I selected Detroit Dark Red for my variety type. So let me show you how to do that. So over here on the right, we're gonna click Add Crop, and it does, these are some I've previously put in. It does flowers as well as vegetables. I'm gonna go ahead and do a marigold. Here's marigold. The crop variety. So I bought these marigolds a couple of years ago and I don't remember, so I'm gonna call it the I don't know variety. And then for the label, I'm gonna say saved seeds from 2021. Okay, so the nice thing is they already had marigolds in their system, so I don't need to use this, but I will show you what this is. This is the advanced settings. And it already has all this information in their database for a marigold variety. So it already knows that you want to put them, start the seeds 4 weeks before the last frost indoors, and then you would transplant them 42 days later. If you don't want to transplant and you want to direct seed, you can click on here for that option. And then down here, it talks about spacing. It knows that marigolds need 12 inches per each marigold you place in the ground. So you can do 12 inches as they suggest, or you can change it to whatever is good for you. And then it tells you in 70 days, that's when they're going to start maturing. So if you wanna change any of this for your, you like to do it different, you can change that, but I'm gonna leave it as it is. And then my marigolds are actually kind of like a red color, so I'm gonna change it to this red. That way, when it shows up in the calendar over here, it'll be more this red color. And then I'm gonna go ahead and schedule it in. It's over here thinking. It's going to add it to my plants over here on the left, and it's also going to input it into the calendar here. So now let's look for the marigolds. Okay, here it is in the calendar. So I went right here to the search bar to type in marigold. And I can see that I need to start my seeds inside around March 21st. And then on May 2nd, I will transplant them outside. And on the 30th, I can quote unquote harvest my flowers. So that's when they're gonna be optimal and fully grown, is on the 30th. Another feature that they have in here is, if I go to task filter, they also will tell you when you need to start prepping your bed and cultivating your bed. So there's some more information there, and they have videos on what each of these mean. What does it mean to seed? What does it mean to bed prep and transplant and cultivate and harvest? So I like to only have Awesome. So we have my marigolds in here. I wanted to show you something really awesome. Is my family's coming to visit in April. Let me clear marigolds from the search. This is what is going on in April. I am direct seeding at the beginning of April, and at the end of April, I'm already harvesting. So I can see when my family is visiting, which dates they're coming, what I'm going to be busy doing. And maybe they'll be willing to help me direct seed some of these into the garden or even start some seeds. So that's really awesome to see what all I have going on looking forward. Now, let me take you to my garden. Okay, so these are my raised garden beds that you have may or may not have seen footage of me in. Over here on the left, you can grab a shape of whatever container you're going to be planting in. So my container is a raised square or a rectangle. So here's a garden bed, and I place it in there, and then I drag it to the dimensions that it is. So if this was one of my raised garden beds, or maybe it's just a plot of land, this would be 26 feet by 10 inches and then 8 feet down here. You can customize it. If it's not a perfect rectangle, you can change it to, well, it actually looks a little bit more like this. And then you make sure that the measurements are correct. So for the measurements, you can come in here and type in, well, actually the width is 7.7 and the length is 31.4, and then we can apply it. And I don't like that color for the soil. I'm gonna put like yellow. All right, and then apply. So you can do that. And it is important to make it as close to the exact dimensions that yours is, because let me show you this cool feature. We can plant our crops in here that you already put into the system. So on the left here, you're gonna hit crops. And then I wanna plant my marigolds. Marigolds, all right. Okay, see where this green is? We're currently in February, so there's no marigolds in the ground. You start the marigolds in March inside. So that's still not in the ground. And then it's not until May over here that you transplant them. So I want the marigolds, I'm trying to click on them, it won't let me. You just come up here, say jump to May 2nd. So now you're in the timeline, in the future, this is what May 2nd looks like. And all this color, these are all the plants I've already put in the ground. And I have, before making this video, I went in and designed where everything was going. I haven't put in the marigolds yet, so now I can see, okay, there's lots of room here, there's lots of room here, but actually there isn't, because if you guys know my garden, in this bed here we have the asparagus and strawberries, and this bed here is all herbs. So I'll probably put some marigolds over it here. So let me pull the marigolds up down. I'm going to go ahead and put the marigold in there. And it's real tiny because marigolds are a small plant, so let me zoom in. Alright, there's my marigold. Okay. And because the software knows the spacing for the plants, it is putting space between them that is appropriate for the marigold variety. So I'm going to go ahead and put some marigolds here. I'm going to duplicate that. Tomatoes. Here we go. So as you see, in May, the garden is going to be very colorful and beautiful. So May would be a great time to be taking pictures and video. So here's my marigolds, and I'll just walk through the garden and show you what I have planned. This is really cool. So over here, this is where I had potatoes and garlic last year. This year I'm going to be putting corn and green beans there. And so if you look at the bottom here, at the corn, right below my cursor, it says there's 103 corn plants. So that's how many I could fit in this space. it's 103. And then on top of the corn, I have per row 16 green blue lake beans. So 16 by there's 7 corn here would be 120 green bean plants, and then I have the corn. So this is a lot, but the really nice thing is it shows you visually what's going on in the garden, and it mathematically tells you what you can fit with the appropriate spacing for your plants. Which reminds me, I want to show you the tasks. So the tasks each week, it will tell you what you need to do. So this week I needed to seed kohlrabi and my cabbages, which I've already done. So I just click on it by saying it's completed, and then it doesn't tell me I need to do that. And then I can go to next week. Do I have anything I need to do next week? Yes, next week I need to start seeding my lettuce. Oh, and let's see. Let's go to like April. My family's in town. I think this is about the week they're in town. It's stinking. Oh, yeah. See, there's all this stuff I need to do. Actually, these ones are overdue. Hang on. You can see because they're in the red. Okay, here we go. All of this needs to happen when my family's in town. But we could also see this while we're in the calendar. I'm going to go ahead and go over here to the journal. So I've already started seeds inside. These I started on February 6th, and these were my onions. These were in my last video. So I entered a note in there that I planted 12 of each. And then this is what I did this morning. I have my kohlrabi, it's the purple here, put it in there. And I noted that in each box I had so many, which made a total of 48 kohlrabi plants that I should be getting. I tagged it with kohlrabi, I said seeding. And I'm gonna go ahead and put it in for, I haven't done my cabbage yet. So I'm gonna put cabbage, seeding, and this was done, it was actually done on Saturday, so I'm gonna put Saturday. I did it with my mother-in-law. Seeded cabbage with mom. 8x5, so that'd be 40 each. And the type of plants I did were the red cabbage and... So these cabbages, it's pulling from the crops I've already input into their system. Awesome. So then we have here is my red cabbage and my green cabbage. Seeded cabbage with mom, 40 each. Okay, looks good. And then I'm gonna hit save. I forgot to do something. Oh, awesome. So it put in that they are in the raised bed because I've already told the system where I want to put the cabbage once I put it into the ground. Okay, so I thought I needed to put those tags in there, but I don't. I do want to add a seeding tag. Okay, there we go. Save. And something really awesome is you can search right here. I don't remember when I did onions. Oh, here we go. This is when I did onions, February 6th. And let's see, when did I can even search the word mom because I have the word mom in each of these entries. So, okay, yeah, this is what I seeded with my mom. I just think this is a really wonderful tool. It makes it so much easier to keep track of everything. And if you think this is something that would help you, remember it is free, so. It is free. You just click on get my free account and you will get $5 of free seeds. There are in the software, you can upgrade, which is a cost. But other than that, you're able to utilize the tools that I've shown you. They are a company that doesn't operate on the weekends. So let me show you their store. Over here, there's a store. So I wasn't even able to look at their seeds over the weekend because their shop is closed on the weekends. So keep that in mind if you want to purchase anything. So go ahead and check out the site. It's completely free. If you decide it's not for you, then it's not for you, but I really love it and I'm really excited to utilize it and have it help me stay organized this season. I will be posting more content than normal, if you haven't noticed. We are on Instagram and we are now doing YouTube shorts. If ever you see something that you like, please let us know or engage with it, because that helps us out. And I am excited to share with you what's going on this season in our garden. I also will continue to be showing other videos about the farm and farm projects. So this is not just an exclusively YouTube gardening channel, but we are getting into that season, so there's going to be a lot more of that content coming up. And teaser, we are going to be opening up a farm stand and building a farm stand. So I'm really excited to show that to you once it's all polished and ready. So thanks for watching.